for the warning. We'll take care of them.
I see you, Shepard.
Fuck.
Use overload on him.
We should have expected this.
Come on, we can still catch them.
Wow, they're actually telling me where the objective is.
They did want to get to Vito first.
Get your squad into cover, and I'll open the loading bay doors.
We'll take cover by the doors. Shepard, you take point.
Taking cover. On it. Take point, Shepard. We'll cover the door. Going to ground.
By the doors. Shepard, you take point. Understood.
Heavy armor plating. Those Quarians never stood a chance.
This is gonna be one tough son of a bitch to take down.
Target locked.
Overload will take out their shield.
Grab the med kit.
This is your chance to go find Vitor while I tend to the wounded, Shepard. He's probably somewhere in the back of the loading bay.
Okie dokie.
This looks interesting.
Like up here. More credits, alright. Above that, what kind of credits do I have at this point? Realize there's no inventory.
Swarms can't find. Monsters coming. Have to hide.
Nobody's gonna hurt you anymore.
I don't think he can hear you, Commander.
Have to hide. Mechs will protect. Swarms coming. Storm coming. Storm of swarms. No escape. No hope. Can't. Human, where did you hide? How come they didn't find you?
Who didn't find us?
The monsters, the swarms. They took everyone.
Why didn't the colonists fight back, Vitor? What happened?
You don't know. You didn't see. But I see everything.
Looks like security footage. He must have pieced it together manually.
What the hell is that?
My God. I think it's a collector.
I thought the collectors kept it themselves.
They usually work through intermediaries, like slavers or hired mercenaries. If they're involved with the Reapers somehow, it could explain what happened to the colonies.
The collectors have advanced technology. They could have a weapon that disables an entire settlement at once.
The Seeker swarms. No one can hide. The Seekers find you, freeze you, then the monsters take you away.
Why didn't the collectors take you?
Swarms didn't find me. Monsters didn't know I was here.
The collectors aren't known for being careless. Maybe his enviro suit kept him from showing up on their sensors.
Or they were using technology specifically designed to detect humans. Only human colonies have been hit.
Tell me more about these swarms.
It's how they find you. Seeker clouds, machines like tiny insects. They go everywhere. They find you, then they sting you, freeze you.
Sounds like miniature probes, maybe. Find victims, then immobilize them with a stasis field or nerve toxin.
I want to know more about the collectors.
Nobody knows much. They're so rare, a lot of people don't even believe they exist.
More importantly, why are they abducting human colonists? What are they after?
Maybe the elusive man can figure it out.
What happened next?
The monsters took the people onto the ship, and then they left. The ship flew away. But they'll be back for me. No one escapes.
I think that's probably all we're getting out of him, Commander.
We appreciate what you told us. You were very helpful.
I studied them. The monsters. The swarms. I recorded them with my Omni tool. Lots of readings. Electromagnetic. Dark energy.
We need to get this data to the elusive man. Grab the quarry and call the shuttle to come pick us up.
What? Vitor is injured. He needs treatment, not an interrogation.
We won't hurt him. We just need to see if he knows anything else. He'll be returned unharmed.
Your people tried to betray us once already. If we give him to you, we'll never get the intel we need.
Praza was an idiot, and he and his men paid for it. You're welcome to take Vitor's Omnitool data, but please, Just let me take him.
You don't have to take Vitor and go. We could work together, just like old times.
I'm still trying to accept that you're even alive, and you're with Cerberus. I've got responsibilities now. I've got a mission of my own. I can't walk away from that. Not even for you.
He's traumatized and he needs medical care. Tally will give us the Omnitool data and take him to the flotilla.
Understood, Commander.
Thank you, Shepard. I'm glad you're still the one giving the orders. Good luck out there. If I find anything that can help you, I'll let you know.
We're ready for pickup.
Shepard, good work on Freedom's Progress. The Quarians forwarded their findings from Vitor's debriefing. No new data, but it's a surprising olive branch given our history. You and I have different methods, but I can't argue with your results.
The data from his Omnitool should be quite useful.
We're still analyzing it. But more importantly, you confirm the Collectors are behind the abductions.
Tell me what you know about these Collectors.
They periodically travel to the Terminus systems, looking to gather seemingly unimportant items or specimens, usually in exchange for their technology. When their transactions are complete, they disappear as quickly as they arrive, back beyond the unmapped Omega 4 relay. Until now, we've had no evidence of direct aggression by the Collectors.
Any ideas on why they've shifted their focus to humans?
If they're agents for the Reapers, it could be any number of reasons. Obviously, humanity played a huge role in Sovereign's destruction. That might have been enough to draw their attention. What really concerns me is why they bother abducting the colonists. Once the humans are paralyzed, why not just kill them?
Why is the Omega 4 relay unmapped? What do we know about it?
Only that no ship passing through it has ever returned. Our best guess is that the relay reacts differently to Collector vessels, allowing them safe passage. If they can manipulate relays, that's just further evidence of the connection with the Reapers.
What are the Collectors getting from these deals?
The Collectors aren't very forthcoming about their motives. Generally, they seek out species with rare genetic mutations or abnormalities. They pay slavers and merc groups exorbitant sums to obtain these specimens, and then they leave. But they've never targeted a single species before, and the previous sample sizes were in the dozens, not the tens of thousands.
The Collectors are definitely a human enemy, but how do we know there's a connection to the Reapers?
Their focus shifted to humanity only after you and the human fleet destroyed Sovereign. The abductions are related, even if the Alliance and the Council refuse to believe it. I won't wait until the Reapers are on the march. We need to take the fight to them.
I hate waiting, but I'll need a team. A good one.
I've already compiled a list of soldiers, scientists, and mercenaries. You'll get dossiers on the best of them. Finding them and convincing them to work with you could be challenging, but you're a natural leader. I'll continue to track the Collectors. When they make their next appearance, I'll notify you and your team. Be ready.
I'm still a Spectre. Maybe I can get the Council to help us out.
If you think you can convince them, by all means. Just remember, you've been gone a long time. Things have changed.
You worry about the Collectors. I'll make sure my team's ready.
Good. Two things before you go. First, head to Omega and find Morden Solas. He's a brilliant Solarian scientist. Our intelligence suggests he may know how to counteract the Collectors' paralyzing Seeker swarms.
Sounds good. What else?
I've found a pilot I think you might like. I hear he's one of the best. Someone you can trust.
Hey, Commander. Just like old times, huh?
I can't believe it's you, Joker.
Look who's talking. I saw you get spaced.
Got lucky, with a lot of strings attached. How'd you get here?
It all fell apart without you, Commander. Everything you stirred up, the Council just wanted it gone. The team was broken up, record sealed, and I was grounded. The Alliance took away the one thing that mattered to me. Hell yeah, I joined Cerberus.
You really trust the Elusive Man?
Well, I don't trust anyone who makes more than I do. But they aren't all bad. Saved your life, let me fly, and there's this. They only told me last night.
Oh, awesome shot.
It's good to be home, huh, Commander?
I guess we'll have to give her a name.
Welcome aboard the new Normandy, Commander.
I've been looking over the dossiers. I'd strongly recommend starting by acquiring Morden Solus, the Solarian professor on Omega. We know the Collectors use some type of advanced technology to immobilize their victims. We'll need him to develop a countermeasure to protect us.
Without that countermeasure, we'll be helpless if we ever run into the Collectors.
Acquiring Professor Solus seems like the most logical place to start.
Who are you?
I am the Normandy's artificial intelligence. The crew like to refer to me as Edie.
Having an AI in charge of the Normandy system should give us an advantage.
Actually, I am not in control of the ship, Commander. Due to the potential dangers of a rogue AI, Cerberus has severely restricted my capabilities. During combat, I operate the electronic warfare and cyber warfare suites. Beyond that, I cannot interface with the ship's systems. I observe and offer analysis and advice. Nothing more.
Now that we've established who's in charge, let's move on to these dossiers.
Final preparations for takeoff are complete, Commander. When you're ready to go, just pick a destination from the galaxy map and the CIC and I'll plot a course.
Jacob and I should return to our posts. Come find us if you have any questions.
I know how that works. Private terminal gets status updates on the squad. Okay. Armory. Elevator. Captain's quarters. Tech lab. I need to find that professor guy. Okay. lot of stuff, so what? Convict.
Welcome aboard, Commander.
Alright, we're fine, we're people warned.
A scientist is required to use the technical laboratory.
No one's in there. Oh, I got some renegade, I guess. Don't know how. Another DLC, I guess. Here's Jacob.
Commander, there hasn't been time to really settle in and take stock. I want to say that working with you is a great opportunity to do something that matters. It's a privilege to serve on the Normandy, Commander.
You may change your tune if we end up like the original Normandy.
Maybe. As long as the elusive man walks his talk, and you do the same, I'll do my best to make sure we succeed. That's been the condition for my service so far. I have issues with certain actions Cerberus has taken in the past.
It's good to hear a clear opinion. Sounds like we're two of a kind.
That honors me more than you, Commander. Let me know if you need anything.
Joker would like to see you up on the bridge, Commander.
Oh yeah, he didn't think it was talking to Joker.
Can you believe this, Commander? It's my baby! Better than new! It fits me like a glove! And leather seats. Military may set the hardware standard, but on a first-gen frigate, they could care less if the seats breathe. Civilian sector comfort by design.
The reproduction is not intended to be perfect, Mr. Moreau. Seamless improvements were made.
And there's the downside. I liked the Normandy when she was beautiful and quiet. Now she's got this thing I don't want to talk about. It's like ship cancer.
It's not the same, Joker. There's nothing here that was even part of the real Normandy.
There's us. I have to take what I can get. The last 2 years sucked. You'll see. Even if an AI is spying on us, no way they'll invest this much just to screw us over. It'll be better than the old days.
I hope so. I die.
Yeah, you are such a downer.
Yeah, definitely did die. And this elevator's not fun, like though in a Mass Effect. It's long and boring, and that's just a long one.
Chef surprise again? Come on, Rupert.
I'm sorry, Princess. Filet mignon and caviar coming right up. Commander Shepard, the hero of the Citadel, you did humanity proud that day. Miss Sergeant Rupert Gardner here. How can I be of service?
You have everything you need.
I make do, but have you ever tried to prepare a decent meal with military provisions? I'm good, but I'm no miracle worker. Taking down the collectors is going to be rough business. The crew deserves a few fine meals before they throw themselves into the fire.
What do you need?
If I had some quality ingredients... Oh, shit. You've got more to worry about than grocery shopping on the Citadel. Forget I mentioned it.
If I head that way, I'll keep an eye out.
Much appreciated. Most of this list is probably standard fare for those namby-pambies on the Citadel. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
I won't take any more of your time.
Back to work.
Why the fuck do I look so fucking weird? Ah, she gets her own fucking office.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
No doubt you've got a lot of questions. Cerberus isn't as evil as most people believe. If I can help allay any of your concerns, I'd be happy to do so. So, what would you like to know?
Tell me about yourself, Miranda.
Well, I guess that's fair. I've spent the last 2 years learning everything there is to know about you. Well, you should probably know that I've had extensive genetic modification. Not my decision, but I make the most of it. It's one of the reasons the elusive man handpicked me. I'm very good at just about anything I choose to do.
You certainly don't lack for confidence.
It's just a fact. My reflexes, my strength, even my looks, they're all designed to give me an edge. No point in hiding from it. It's the reason I'm trusted to oversee the most dangerous, risky, and technically demanding operations Cerberus undertakes. And it's why I was assigned to you. It's my job to make sure you succeed, Shepard.
What level of genetic modification are we talking about?
That's very thorough. Physically, I'm superior in many ways. I heal quickly, and I'll likely live half again as long as the average human. My biotic abilities are also very advanced. For a human. Add to that some of the best training and education money can buy, and... Well, it's pretty impressive, really.
Sounds like you were designed to be perfect.
Maybe. But I'm not. I'm still human, Shepard. I make mistakes like everyone else. And when I do, the consequences are severe. Everyone expects a lot from someone with my... abilities.
Thanks for the information, Miranda. I'll talk to you later.
Of course, Commander. Whatever you need.
Harry. My cabin. Look at my great cabin. I don't care about that enough. That's your Liara. Ah, oh, sweet. Yeah. Yeah, this is some great music. Okay, same turn music off. Alright, let's go. Back down to deck 2, where the map is. I'll look at the map. Maybe we decide where to land. Maybe. I don't know.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Okay. Yes. Put the... So there's... We fly the ship around with him. Unexplored. I got all these kind of places. Thinking about heading to the Citadel before going to the place. So let's land on the Citadel. Alrighty, so I'm gonna end this part off here, and next part we will talk to the capsule most likely. So yeah, but anyways, I've been next time, and I'll see you guys in the next one.